Our third woman of the year, Dr. Cynthia Herrera. She's a passionate advocate for student access to education. We all know that the key to success and opportunity in our lives and in the lives of our families and our children is a good education. It unlocks the doors. It is the hope that we have for our future. And it is critically important that we make these opportunities available to all our children. She is one of those people who has recognized this and has been committed to this for quite some time. She currently serves as the Dean of Institutional Effectiveness at Oxnard College. And prior to that position, she served as the Director of Project Ascension, an initiative to enhance STEM education programs. If these are a lot of fancy words, I do know what STEM stands for. Science, technology, engineering, and math. We've added something to it today, which I'm so pleased. We've added an A for the arts. So it's now STEAM. It was STEM then, but you know, like everything else, we improve as we go on and we add things and we recognize how important these programs are. The STEM program is a partnership from preschool through graduate level. It created a pipeline for our youngsters. You know, this is a different world today than the world many of us knew. When we went to school, in fact, I remember my husband still chides me about the fact that a few years ago I was rallying my supporters and asking them to help me dial for, you know, votes. And he said, "What do you think these young people think you're doing? Nobody dials like this anymore." And the world has changed in that way and in so many. And when my four-year-old can take my iPhone and goes directly to the little app that I had bought her so she could do Thomas the Train, and I say, "How do you get there?" She looks at me and says, "Oh, Nanabeth, it's so easy." It's a different world. And we have to recognize that. And the world is really moving in the direction of science and technology and engineering and math. Of course, we can't forget the arts, and I know that we will not. And Dr. Herrera has been someone who has really made a commitment to making sure that the next generation learns about what future opportunities there are and is educated so that they can achieve those dreams. She's also a founding member of the Ventura County STEM Regional Network, which is a leadership hub for regional stakeholders working together to improve educational outcomes in STEM for all students throughout Ventura County. This is critically important. As we see the world changing, we're fighting for jobs. We keep talking about the need to have good quality jobs in our community. That's how we get them. And she has been a leader and a visionary in making sure that we are well connected with those opportunities here in Ventura County. Now, she's secured, it's nice to talk about things, but you gotta find the Benjamins. In fact, today, before I came here, I was in the Budget Committee. I serve on Budget Sub 1 in the Senate, which is education. You know, we have about, what, $80 billion in our education system. We were talking about these programs. We were talking about these roadmaps and pipelines from high school to college to make sure that our youngsters all understand and have the opportunity to be successful. She was able to secure more than $25 million over the past 6 years in grant initiatives to enhance STEM programs for Oxnard College and its partners. That is an extraordinary accomplishment. As an educator in a community serving underrepresented youth and students, she has worked hard to enhance student success through these programs, which are aimed at increasing educational opportunities for them. She participates as a board member on multiple educational and business advisory committees because, you know, we want to link. We want to make sure we train young people for the jobs that exist. We are going to have a shortage, believe it or not, of about 1 million high-paying jobs in this country over the next 5 to 10 years, Because we aren't doing exactly what it is Dr. Pereira knows we need to be doing. And she has made a commitment to making sure here in Ventura County, we can encourage and entice those companies, and we can provide them with the workforce, the well-educated workforce, that is going to continue to make Ventura County thrive. She has served also as a dedicated volunteer in a variety of different areas. I want to ask whether Jess, her husband, also has dinner ready at the end of the day, because this woman is one busy lady.
Ask her.
Who does? I should have hit that box twice. Without further ado, my woman of the year, Dr. Cynthia Herrera.
Swells my heart. Thank you very much. It's an honor to be recognized today, but I know that I am simply a reflection of every woman in this room. Every woman that I look at has contributed to our society and making our future better. So thank you very much for everything that you do. Ago, I learned that the way to get started, I just do it. Just get started. And I came from a very rural community. My husband would say, country. When I took him out to Michigan, the Midwest, he said, there are no stop signs. There are no police. There's no firefighters. That's right, just farmers. And I was trained to get up at 5:30 in the morning, because by 6 o'clock, you had to milk the cows. And then by 8:30, you had to be in school. And then when you got home, you had to milk the cows again at 6 o'clock in the evening. So we had a regiment, and we know our role. But I also know that in my day, women were very limited in what they could expect out of their life. And I kind of broke that mold. I don't know how I was so God-given grace with doing that, but I do know that there were people in my life that believed in me, encouraged me, and inspired me to make a difference. In high school, it was my track coach who told me, get up front, you can lead these exercises. Probably because I was the skinniest and I was the most willing to work the hardest, I don't know. When I went to college, it was a counselor who told me, you can be more, you can do more, you can see a future beyond what you see now. When I moved to California from Michigan, I didn't know a person, I didn't have a place to live, I didn't have a car, I had a job, that was about it. And I trusted in the Almighty God to help me move forward. In a lot of my move forward, I have to tell you that it was my husband, Jess Herrera, who has supported me endlessly and told me, don't be afraid to move forward, don't be afraid to give. And he has allowed me to be who I am. In my work life, I thank God for the woman that is the president of Oxnard College, Dr. Cynthia Zari, who has really women, who supports the advancement of student success, who is really dedicated to our community of students making a difference. And I just want to say that today, Senator Jackson, thank you for your leadership. You are making a difference for a lot of women in our county whose voices wouldn't necessarily be heard, but because of you, we're being heard. So I thank you very much. I want to congratulate my colleagues who are being recognized today. I feel very inspired by everything that we're doing together. I do believe that there is a lot more to be done, and I put the challenge out for every woman in this room to continue to expand. And I'm going to use a quote from my husband who said, if you want something said, ask a man. If you want something done, get a woman.